get ready to learn about TransPan.
The presets in this plugin all have common controls, but some categories have different features we'll explore. We'll start with this section, using this preset as our example. The first control we'll go over is Edit Mode. To activate it, click on this box. Notice the change in the viewer. Let's get a better look at that. With Edit Mode on, we can see changes to our transition as we make adjustments. We can also see the current slide direction as well as the number of animation cycles. Now, we'll deselect it. Next is the slide direction. The slide direction control affects the direction and amount of cycles in the transition. It's currently set to slide up and left in 2 cycles, and we can set it to 4 cycles in the same direction. Here's what that looks like. With 4 cycles, the transition is faster and more dramatic. Below that, we'll look at slide delay. The slide delay control adjusts the ease in and ease out of the animation. If we increase the value, the animation will start and end more slowly. Let's see it in action. As you can see, the animation has a different style. Our next control is Tilt Amount. The Tilt Amount adjusts how much tilting action occurs during the transition. Now that's a big difference. Following that, we have Dolly Amount. With the Dolly Amount control, the greater the value, the more the subject appears to move closer to the viewer during the animation. Here's how that looks. Continuing on, let's look at rotation. The rotation control determines how much rotation occurs during the transition. Here's a comparison. With max rotation, the clip rotates quite a bit during the transition. Moving on, we'll look at shake. The shake control increases the amount that the clip shakes during the transition. Here it is in action. It's very subtle, but the clip shake as they move. Next, let's adjust the wiggle control. The wiggle control adjusts how much the footage will wiggle during the transition. Here's a comparison. Wow, the wiggle effect adds so much energy to the transition. Down here, we can use the style controls to adjust the colors of the transition. First, the red channel control adjusts how much distortion will occur in the red values. The green channel control adjusts the amount of distortion in the green values. And the blue channel control determines how much distortion occurs in the blue values. Now, let's play it. Now the transition includes some exciting color variation. Now that we've seen all the controls in this category, we'll switch to the next section, using this preset as our example. We've already gone over these controls in the previous section, so we'll skip to the unique controls. The Bounciness control determines how many times the clips will bounce during the transition. Here's a comparison. Just look at that difference. Now, we'll go over the controls in the next section using this preset. We learned how these controls worked in the first section, so we'll skip to the new control. The Elasticity control adjusts the stretchiness of the clips during the transition. Let's see how that looks. as elastic as a rubber band.
Now that you're familiar with all these controls, we can't wait to see how you use this plugin.